So recently, something happened that was kind of depressing. There's this YouTuber, whom I like, we'll leave him nameless, and he makes these little video essays about entertainment and about movies. And they're very good essays, extremely good, very insightful. And they're, you know, whimsical and just a lot of fun, and I'm a big fan, a huge fan as a matter of fact, to the point where I decided that I was going to support this guy with a Patreon donation, a monthly donation of 20 bucks. I thought that my supporting him would be a good thing. I mean, after all, I'm gonna be paying him 20 bucks a month for him to produce his videos. The perk that I would be getting, apart from like being in some live streams that was just for Patreons or something like that, was that I was gonna have my name in the credits at the end. And you know, that was the only perk I was gonna get. That was sort of like noteworthy, but I wasn't really interested in the perks. I was interested in contributing to him because I figured, you know, 20 bucks a month over 12 months, you know, that's $240. It's money that he could use. So I was happy to sign up for that on Patreon. But then I got quite the surprise. Half an hour, you know, not more than an hour after I'd signed up, right? I get this notice from Patreon and saying that this guy that I was going to be supporting to the tune of 20 bucks a month, well, he had declined my patronage and in point of fact had blocked me. And it was just, you know, at first I thought, is there a glitch? And I emailed him, as a matter of fact, because I was so surprised, but you know, I never got a reply. I knew that the guy was a liberal. You know, I knew that the guy was a lefty, but he made good content and very insightful, and his politics were not particularly important insofar as his insights were concerned. And some of the things that he had pointed out in some of his video essays were things that I'd never considered. I found him valuable, irrespective of his politics. And see, with a name like Coach Red Pill, right? I mean, what the fuck you think I am? You think I'm some commie or some socialist? You think I've got like a flag, you know, hailing Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez? Fuck no! I'm a conservative, for crying out loud. But my political perspective does not influence whom I respect or whom I want to be associated with. But that's not the case with leftists. And to tell the truth, the farther left you get, the more into SJW territory you get, the more likely people are to reject you. They will reject you because they think that you have the wrong politics. Because the left is going insane, and what has happened is that they have started to think that their political points of view, their political positions, are in fact moral diktats. They are the expression of the goodness of the person who holds these ideals. And those who are to the left and the extreme left, they think that they are morally better than all those who are to the right or to the extreme right. In point of fact, they think that anybody who's center and right is probably evil, is probably the Antichrist. I know that what I'm saying is, you know, old hat. I mean, like, it's been said by dozens of people tons of times, right? But the fact of the matter is that it was sort of like unnerving to come across it face to face, because I genuinely wanted to help this guy. I thought I was helping him. You know, he's got a YouTube channel. It's fairly large, but not that large. And I know more or less how much money he's bringing in from the ad revenue. And I know, just from gauging how many subscribers he has to his Patreon, how much money more or less he's getting. And the fact that he's living in New York City means that that really isn't enough for him to survive and live comfortably and be able to produce the content that he wants to, the kind of content that I enjoy. That's why I was happy to give him those 20 bucks a month. And he refused them. And he refused them out of hand because of what he thought my politics are. These people are nuts. It's as simple as that. These people are fucking nuts. Let me ask you something. I mean, how sane do you have to be to reject $240 a year? You know, just here, have it, take it. No strings attached. My name is supposed to appear in the credits of his videos, but you know, he could just like say, oh, I forgot to put your name, I'll do it again next time, and you know, keep on forgetting, and you know, I'd probably be like, fine, you know? If he didn't want my name, Coach Red Pill, to appear in his end credits of his videos, well, he could have just lied a little. Or maybe he would have thought that he was being, you know, disingenuous, or worse, think that by not putting my name, he was sort of like, you know, committing some sort of fraud or whatever. I don't know. I don't get it. But the fact remains, see, this guy turned down good money just because he thinks that my politics are not the right sort of politics. This is indicative of something bigger. Okay, just because I'm down about it, it's not really important. What it is important is to realize that, see, there is a segment of the population in the Western democracies that are becoming more and more intransigent. And see, a democracy, in order for it to survive, there has to be compromise. There has to be consensus. You know, people have to give in a little so that they get some of the things that they want. That's the genius of the American democracy. Shelby Foote, the historian, said it best. That ability to compromise is why the United States has endured for over two centuries. And the one time it was unable to come to a compromise, there was a civil war. This incident that happened to me, trivial though it is, it seems to me at least to confirm what I've been thinking for a while, which is that we are headed for a civil war. And it's not gonna happen, you know, next year or the year after that. It's gonna happen in 5 years, 10 years, and it's gonna be bloody, like the Spanish Civil War. And it won't be a nice, clean war like the Civil War, the American Civil War of 1861 to 65, because that one was nice and clean because there was clear territorial divisions. The North believed one thing and the South believed another. But in the environment we're living in now, we're all sort of like interconnected, intertwined, territorially speaking, in terms of location. And so that's why I think it's going to be like the Spanish Civil War. It's going to be a war fought block by block, neighborhood by neighborhood. And it's going to be bloody as hell. Why do I think it's going to be bloody as hell? Very simple. Because you see, you have one side of the political divide that truly believes that it is a moral imperative to think as they do. And those who disagree with their politics, their ideologies, and their ideas, it's not that they're wrong, it's that they're evil. And so when you're willing to demonize the other side, when you're willing to make of them something less than human, and then you're willing to kill them. And you'll be happy to kill them, because see, it's not that you're killing a fellow human being who believes different than you. No, no, no. You are killing the enemy, the evil Nazi, the guy who wants to do untold evil on you and your compatriots, your confederates, your allies. That's what's going on. We've seen it before already. We've seen how leftists have no trouble trying to kill people. Remember the body clock guy, right? And that guy, what happened to him? Well, you know, a sympathetic leftist judge let him walk scot-free. Nothing happened to him. He didn't go to jail or anything, yeah? And we've seen how these leftists attack people who don't agree with them. And they keep saying that it's the right-wingers who attack. Show me evidence, please, because every report I hear, it's always a left-winger who is attacking a right-winger. And the right-winger wasn't doing anything. He was wearing a stupid hat that they didn't like. Or maybe he was white. Or maybe he was a guy. A guy caught in the wrong place at the wrong time. And so they attack. And they don't care because they see that the person that they are attacking is subhuman. Because they think that if you don't agree with them, you're evil. This guy I wanted to support on Patreon, right? He's a smart fellow, obviously. I mean, I wouldn't be supporting him otherwise, or trying to support him otherwise. Now, he's a smart fellow, but I think that he is so closed-minded. And it's a stereotype, you know? The guy's a white guy from an upper-middle-class upbringing. He went to Oberlin College. It's a stereotype of what he thinks. He's a down-the-line leftist. And the one time I disagree with his film analysis, guess which movie it was? Yeah, it was The Last Jedi. He thought it was great, you know? With Admiral Gender Studies and the incredibly stupid plot that emphasized diversity over coherent storytelling? Yeah. And it's sad. It's sad to realize this because I certainly don't want the Western democracies to go down the tubes. I don't want them to become, you know, fall into some civil war. But that's where we're going. And it's not me. And it's not the attitude of people like me, people on the conservative side. It's the people on the left. The people on the left who view people like me as evil just because we think different from them. Okay, so I've ranted enough. So let's move on to the practical thing that you should do, okay? See, you're a smart young man, right? You're not a complete fucking idiot. So you realize that a lot of this SJW social justice bullshit is exactly that, bullshit. And you know that the reasonable political positions are somewhere between the center left and the center right. And some ideas, you know, that are more on the fringes on either side, they have some points, but you know, the middle is more or less where you want to be politically, right? But you are in that middle somewhere, but you come across some SJW, you come across some leftist, right? And so what do you have to do? Well, you have to fucking keep your fucking mouth shut. That's what you have to do. Be smart. Always keep your politics to yourself. I'm a bit of a fool in that regard because I don't have a problem telling people, you know, here, there, everywhere, what my politics are. But you got to go out in the world, in the work world, in your profession. Well, you have to keep your mouth shut and be very circumspect. And it's unfortunate. And people will say, oh, well, coach, you're telling us to cuck out. And I'll say, yeah, fuck yeah, you got to cuck out. Because you got to make sure that these people don't hurt you because they want to hurt you. They are looking to hurt you. The second they find out that you think differently from them, that is the moment when they will try to destroy you. And we see it all the time. And so what are you supposed to do? Be a one-man army? Don't be a fucking idiot. Don't be a retard. See? Because one man against all of these people who are in the throes of this insane ideology, well, one man will not survive. It's as simple as that. If you are able to find people who think like you, like me, who are just reasonable people, right? Well, then you can slowly and very cautiously start to show your true political colors. But if you're not sure, assume the worst. Because these people will fuck you up. Oh yeah, they want to, they need to. Because at heart, they realize that what they believe is incoherent. It is illogical. It just doesn't make sense. It's crazy, okay? And you look at this Green New Deal shit. It's insane. It's unviable financially, ecologically, on every metric. It is just not possible. And yet these retards are pushing it. Like it's an essential thing that if we don't pass this, you know, the world is going to end tomorrow. Or like they say, it's going to end in 12 years, which is just absurd. But they are telling this because they believe it. It is a mistake to think that these people are insincere. They are completely sincere. They believe the bullshit they are spouting. And so with true believers, you have to be ultra careful because those true believers will have no problem picking up a knife and sticking it in your belly. See, a lot of times in this life, you have to make compromises. You have to make compromises, and a lot of times you have to keep your head down, okay? If you're not sure, if you suspect that these people are social justice warriors, or even slightly to the left, you shut up. You be smart. And don't feel bad about it. Don't ever think to yourself that you're being cowardly. See? No. You're being smart. Keep your head down and your spirits up. And recognize that one of two things is going to happen. Either these people will somehow wake up from their psychosis and realize that they're crazy and sort of like try to get back some sanity, or the civil war will come. The civil war will come and, well, we'll probably win because we at least are sane enough to see reality, while these people cannot.